that though. Ain't no intro right now. Know what I'm saying? What up to the whole 100 mob and all that other good stuff. I'm going to let you know why we do what we do straight up, bro. Because you haters need to understand why we even do this media coverage the way we do it. You know what I'm saying? We got to let all y'all know how we coming and the truth that we bring. You see what I'm saying? So if you don't understand the intros, you don't like it, it is what it is. Know what I'm saying? Straight up and down. You don't have to like the intro. You know what I'm talking about? It's supposed to be insults. Now, that's how I'm rocking.com/you. Bitch, you understand me? Now, with all this being said, man, we got to talk about Trap Boy Freddy. You know what I'm saying? And we got to talk about a great deal of things that's flowing around the Texas circuit. You see what I'm saying? As far as the streets go, you know what I'm saying? Not just Oak Cliff, you know what I'm saying? And we're not going to get deep into the streets, you know what I'm saying, as far as this go, but we will touch on it a little bit. And part of what we're touching on is the whole Mo3 situation, of course. You know what I'm saying? Now, of course, if y'all look up on YouTube, you will see that Yella Beezy and Trap Boy Freddy, they actually went live. And as they was going live, you see what I'm saying? He played a diss song that was supposed to be allegedly towards Mo3. You understand what I'm saying? And he ended up ending the live, you know what I'm saying, right after Trap Boy Freddy got off. And this indicates that he was actually trying to call him behind the scenes, maybe, and trying to ask him about, you know what I'm saying, as far as what's going on with him just coming out the way he coming out now. With him celebrating what happened to Mo3, you know, you can't automatically say that Trap Boy Freddy had something to do with it, I guess. You see what I'm saying? Because they was already at odds before that happened. And Mo3 was at odds with a lot of people. Now, everybody keeps saying about this guy that I put up there in recent videos that he was just a pawn and all of this. Now, whether he was a pawn or not, he definitely was seen in one of Yella Beezy's photos at a video shoot, I think, or something. So, obviously, he couldn't be too disconnected from the situation. You understand? So, with Trap Boy Freddy celebrating this, what I'm trying to explain is he putting a bad taste in a lot of people as far as Texas DJs and as far as the radio stations in a bad position to where he may be blackballed. You understand? And I'm not saying he is, but this is the question, you know. Is he on his way to being blackballed? You see, is it over for him if he keep on doing what he doing? Now, I know he got a heavy support system. And the boy music straight. He ain't no boy. You see what I'm saying? But the man music straight. And that's real talk. And we can't deny that. And the realness is that he came out and we went up on that live and he did what he did, and all this celebrations is just putting people to the point where maybe they're not gonna respect him when he come around as far as his music and as far as standing behind the movement. And this could trickle over to Yella Beezy. You understand, with him being so close to Trap Boy Freddy and actually being one of the pioneers to this whole music thing when it come to they side of Texas anyway. You know what I'm saying? When you speak about, you know, rappers from a certain section, Mo3, Trap Boy Freddy, you got a lot of people that even come up. You know, Roy Lee even come up because he was attached to the situation. But all of this cannot be put on Trap Boy Freddy just because he's celebrating from my eyes, because you don't want to say nobody automatically guilty and try to implement him. But is he implementing himself? You know what I'm saying? I just don't want to say it, but we all see what time it is. I mean, why? You know, when you could lose everything from doing that. You see, so we got to have a clear vision of what we pumping people up to do. And I mean fans. Now, I'm not blaming the fans for nothing. You see what I'm saying? I'm not blaming no bloggers for nothing. What I am saying is, if somebody do a celebration, if most of the comments was, man, come on, man, respect the dead, man, or something like that, you know, somebody was getting on somebody's head for doing that, and I'm talking about 90% of the comments was bad, a lot of rappers wouldn't do it, because rappers do what other rappers do. If it was never cool to disrespect the dead, you see what I'm saying, as far as rapping, you know what I'm saying, whatever the first rapper was to do it, some said, you know what I'm saying, it was Gucci Man, you know, with the truth, you know. It's probably rappers that did it before him. Now, all I'm saying is, it wasn't popular until now. And if this is all we got to offer after it happened, then it may be something that's going on within the people. you know what I'm saying, that promote it. And that's all that is. So I'm not sitting here saying and pointing the finger to nobody. But what I am saying is a lot of DJs and a lot of people is not about to play him like that, you know, if he keep on with this behavior. Now, he gonna lay low. He got bread. He doing what he gotta do to make hot music, and he's still putting out music. But at the same time, Trap Boy Freddy has been in his own incidents to where, you know, he been hit up and stuff like that. So don't nobody know what happened in that situation, who sent that. And then Mo3 said before he left here that the real is, you know, it won't no car crash and somebody hit you up and stuff like that. How Mo3 know that? Know what I'm saying? I'm saying, you know what I mean? They ain't say it, they ain't make it up. Know what I'm saying? All I'm saying is this, though. Whatever happened, you know what I'm saying? For him to be celebrating so hard, we don't know what really transpired until it all comes out. Like I said, Trap Boy Freddy been in a situation where they got him one time, you know, and he made the best out of the situation and came through. Everybody don't come through. And this is where everybody got to be smart. You know what I'm saying? Like, these intros is all right and all of that or whatever, but on the real talk, you know what I'm saying? The message is everything at the end of the day, because we don't want to keep seeing rappers perish, man, over something crazy, for real, for real. Like I say, make money, box it out. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to go back to saying that, you know what I'm saying? Because there's a lot of money in it. You know what I'm saying? Y'all niggas stop playing. YFN Lucci up on Vlad TV talking about people don't nobody want to get their ass whooped on camera. You know what I'm saying? Well, a lot of rappers need to start wanting to. With that being said, I'm out.